Hello students, today we are understanding the last heading in the magnetization, that is the relation. We are understanding here the relation among different magnetization terms, that are capital M, capital H, this term is chi, susceptibility, then this is magnetic field B, and this is mu, permeability. Okay, so how these terms are interconnected with each other, for that we need to understand this example. Now, let us take a device. You already know the name of this device. This is a solenoid. Okay, suppose if we pass a current in the solenoid, then interior of the solenoid, the magnetic field B will be produced. Okay, so what B is produced inside the solenoid? We have already derived its formula, that is mu zero Ni. Okay, so when a solenoid is air cored, that means air is filled in the windings, then some magnetic field is produced, that is called mu zero Ni. So here B zero is produced, okay, in the interior. Now suppose we introduce a material in the solenoid. Now this material is having non-zero magnetization. Okay, that means we already have studied that inside the materials, due to the circulating electrons, the magnetic dipoles are developed or magnetic moment is developed. So some of the materials carry zero magnetization, zero net magnetization, but some materials have non-zero magnetization. Okay, so we have to take any material which has non-zero magnetization. That means you can say that it is also a magnet. This core is already possessing magnetization, and this it is kept inside the solenoid. So that means now in the interior of the solenoid, the total magnetic field is due to two factors. One is due to this material, and one is due to this current carrying solenoid. So what is the net magnetic field B inside the solenoid now? So you can see total magnetic field B inside the solenoid now is addition of B0 and Bm. B0 means you already have seen that due to the current flowing in the solenoid, magnetic field B0, that means mu0 Ni, was produced. So B0 is due to the solenoid's current. Okay, and Bm, now you can see that material is also there. So it is also producing some magnetic field because it has the circulating electrons. Due to that electrons inside it, magnetic moment is there. Okay, so due to all that effect, we will call its magnetic field Bm. So this is due to the material property. Okay, because some material will possess magnetization and some material will not possess magnetization. So here we have taken the material which possesses magnetization. Okay, now we can convert this B0 and Bm by new terms which are introduced here, that are mu 0 H. That means B0 we have to write as mu 0 H. How it is? Because H is defined as Ni. Okay, this H is defined as Ni. So you see, actual B0 was mu 0 Ni. If we separate mu 0 from it, remaining is considered H. Okay, this is also a kind of magnetic field only. We can call it magnetic intensity. So B0 is converted as mu 0 H. So H is Ni. Okay, H detail let us understand. H is Ni and its unit will be ampere upon meter, because current is in ampere and n, small n means number of turns per unit length. So per unit length means meter will come in upon. So ampere per meter is the unit of H. In the same manner, let us proceed to the second factor now. See, as I've told you, this Bm is the magnetic field due to this material. Okay, so due to this material, what is magnetization produced? That is we called mu 0 capital M. Capital M is called magnetization. ओके मैग्नेटाइजेशन. सो फॉर द यूनिट कन्वर्जन्स एंड ऑल वी हैव टू पुट ईयर म्यू जीरो. ओके सो बी जीरो वी हैव रिटन म्यू जीरो एच एंड बी एम वी हैव रिटन म्यू जीरो एम. नाउ बिकॉज दिस इज अबाउट मटीरियल, अबाउट दिस मटीरियल, सो वी हैव टू डिस्कस दिस कैपिटल एम फॉर द मटीरियल. ओके नाउ हाउ दिस कैपिटल एम इज डिफाइंड दैट यू हैव टू लर्न दिस फॉर्मूला. नेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट डेवलप्ड इन दिस मटीरियल ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अपॉन वॉल्यूम. ओके सो नेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम इज कॉल्ड कैपिटल एम. ओके एंड इट्स यूनिट इज ऑल्सो कमिंग एम्पियर अपॉन मीटर ओनली. हाउ इट इज बिकॉज मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट हैज द यूनिट एम्पियर मीटर स्क्वायर एंड वॉल्यूम हैज द यूनिट मीटर क्यूब. सो दिस वे कैपिटल एम यूनिट विल कम हियर एम्पियर अपॉन मीटर. ओके सो हियर कैपिटल एम इज नॉट डाइपोल मोमेंट, रिमेंबर दिस पॉइंट. हियर कैपिटल एम इज मैग्नेटाइजेशन विच इज नेट डाइपोल मोमेंट अपॉन वॉल्यूम. ओके फाइन. नाउ व्हाट वी हैव डन, वी वर डूइंग टोटल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इनसाइड द सोलेनॉइड व्हेन मटीरियल इज इंसर्टेड. सो टोटल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इनसाइड द सोलेनॉइड इज मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू इट्स ओन करंट, दैट मीन्स म्यू जीरो एन आई फॉर्मूला. ओके एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू द मटीरियल, दैट इज बी एम फॉर्मूला. नाउ दिस म्यू जीरो एन आई फॉर्मूला वी कैन ऑल्सो राइट एज म्यू जीरो एच टू सेपरेट म्यू जीरो एंड दिस बी एम फॉर्मूला वी कैन राइट एज म्यू जीरो एम. नाउ म्यू जीरो इज टेकन कॉमन. ओके म्यू जीरो एच इज इन बोथ. But here this capital M, how it is connected with this H? Okay, how this is connected with this H? You can see the relation between M and H written here. M and H can also be interconnected by one factor that is called chi. Okay, so M equal to chi H. Chi means susceptibility of the material. Okay, now what is the meaning of this chi? Just understand, you see, H means Ni, that means effect of current. So you see, current is present in this coil. Okay, current is present in this coil. And M means this material's magnetization. Okay, which was already having magnetization. But when it is kept inside this solenoid, how this magnetization is affected? This current in the coil. So current is external factor which may apply the effect on the material's magnetization. Okay, so M and H are also interconnected. H means effect of current will also have some effect on magnetization. So how, what is the effect that we can connect by this formula? So replace this M now by chi H. And finally, you can see we have got this type of relation. In that mu zero can be taken common, 1 plus chi H is remaining. 1 plus chi is further called mu R, that means relative permeability. Okay, so 1 plus chi equal to mu R, this relation you remember. Finally, mu zero mu R is, you already know, permeability of the medium of this material, mu H. So this way we have here so many relations which we have to remember. So M and H are related by chi, B and H are related by mu factor, and 1 plus chi is mu R. Mainly these three relations you should remember. Okay, now we can solve a numerical of this pattern in which these relations will be using. Now here we have a question from NCERT solved example which is based on these relations. Question is, a solenoid has a core of material with relative permeability 400. So we have this first data, mu R means relative permeability, it is 400. The windings of the solenoid are insulated from core and carry current of 2 ampere. So current, second data is current 2 ampere. Number of turns 1000 per meter. So n means small n. Small n means number of turns per unit length. that is given 1000. So these three data are given. Now using these three values, we'll be solving H, M, and B. First of all, H formula, remember, Ni. So N is 1000 into I is 2. So final answer is 2000. Unit of H is ampere upon meter. First data is solved. In the same manner, second data is M. Okay. Now, once we have solved H, we can solve M by the relation M equal to chi H. Okay. Now, this chi means susceptibility. It is not given, but it is related with mu r by this formula. So, you know, 1 plus chi is mu r. So, chi is mu r minus 1. Mu r is given 400 minus 1. So, it will become 399. Okay. So, using this chi means 399 and multiplying it with this h value 2000, we will get this m answer. It will be coming around 8 into 10 raised to power 5 ampere per meter. Same manner, now we have the third data, B. Now for solving B, apply mu h formula. Okay, h is already solved. How B and H are connected, as I have told you, by mu. So mu means mu 0 mu r. This we all the time use. So mu means permeability of medium. And mu 0 means permeability of air. That we already know. Mu 0 means 4 pi into 10 raised to power minus 7. Mu r is 400 into H is 2000. Putting all these values, we'll get B answer as approximately 1 Tesla. Okay,